For some species, nesting or shelter locations can be a serious limiting factor in their population growth. For example, scarlet macaws require tall, hollow trees as nesting sites, which they are unable to make themselves. The number of trees that are damaged enough to be hollow inside, while not yet falling over, is a serious limiting factor in their environment. For big cats, shelter or den sites are not an issue, as young are born and raised in any kind of cover in the landscape. Cats are not necessarily picky. This is especially the case if the cat species is the dominant predator in the landscape, having little to fear from other predator species. Usually here, the main threat to offspring comes from intraspecific aggression. This means that cat species are not necessarily tied to landscape features for shelter or raising young. They are, however, tied to cover, as needed for their stalk and pounce hunting strategy. All cat species require creeping up, undetected, to their prey within a relatively short distance. Subsequently, they need to cover the last stretch in a short, accelerated sprint before prey can escape. Most prey species actually have superior top speeds and stamina, with surprise and acceleration being the cat's main weapon. Even the top sprinter in the world, the cheetah, being able to reach top speeds of 110 km per hour, has a minimal distance at which it will start its run to catch gazelles. The cheetah can only sustain these top speeds for a short period. Cats are not coursing animals like dog species, who use superior stamina to follow prey relentlessly and tire them out to the point of no escape. The stalk strategy of cats requires sufficient number of ambush locations in the landscape and thus large expanses of clear open areas without cover are not useful for hunting. In the more open, flatter landscapes, cats require tall grass and other features. Sufficient level of cover is therefore the only landscape feature requirement for cats.